Okay, y'all listen to that. Turn it back on. Okay, watch your live. You gotta watch it.
You just tag.
I know, but you gotta watch my live and then see. There we go. Gotcha. I'm about to bring you on, girl. Yes.
Put your pick it up.
Why can't I bring you on camera?
Yeah. But
say
what we did.
I stay silky, forming colognes. I keep Coogee sweats in, cause that's that good shit. I stay laced with everybody that's on camera. Where you at? Flooded with diamonds and stuff. I have a dozen hundred bags in my drive. I'm trying to have it mild and fly with it. You were bad. I should have kept it real when I was with you. Instead, I missed you. So now I miss you.
There we go. We're getting it together, y'all. We're sorry.
Call it Feel Good Flavor here on Afternoon Delight Radio Show. Clay Mercer in the driver's seat with you on this rainy hump day. Make sure you all stay tuned. We got a chance for you to win a hot and ready piece of dinner from our friends over at Little Caesars. Your chance to win is coming up. And as I told you before, we got some special guests in the building. If you go to our Facebook page, the WRVS-899 Facebook page, you can watch them right now. They're having a lot of fun in the studio, and we're going to have a whole lot of fun here. The Weave Diva herself, Miss Tishima Gramby, is with us. Tishima, thank you so much for coming through and blessing me. It's been a while since we've been together.
It's been a minute.
Yeah, but you back in here. You know about this Feel Good Flavor. And listeners, they're going to give some requests for some songs from Aaliyah and a few others, Monica. So make sure y'all stay tuned for all of that. But we have a lot to get to today. A lot of special guests here, and we're going to talk about everybody that you can see right now, again, on our Facebook page. Tishima, let's jump right into it. Of course, we're going to get into QOD, which is Queen of Diamonds. We're going to talk a whole lot about that, but I want to kind of go from the beginning, because some of our listeners, or a majority of my listeners, probably know you and they've worked with you before, but some may not. So they may not know that you studied business marketing here at ECSU on this campus. So yes, she's a Viking. It's a beautiful thing. How did the lessons learned as a Viking help cultivate this empire of yours?
Well, you know, I didn't graduate, but I decided I was finished.
Mm-hmm.
But seriously, though,
I felt like, you know, I went to school for early childhood education. I got my 2-year degree at COA.
Mm-hmm.
Then I transferred here and took up business and marketing because I felt like I just wanted to know more about business and marketing. Yeah. Like, what's the point of having a business if you can't reach your audience?
That's right.
So I just wanted to, you know, brush up on learning the business.
Mm-hmm.
Definitely not just the business, but like I said, the marketing side. Because you can have a good product, but if you don't know how to market your product, it's just going to be standing on the shelf.
That's very true.
It was important for me to get some education in that.
And speaking of marketing, you do an outstanding job. You've used social media so well, whether it's Instagram or Facebook. I mean, where does that come from? How did you learn all about how promoting and how important that was to what you want to do?
I mean, I think it went back to, you know, watching some other people that I thought, man, like McDonald's, like they keep running the same commercial all day, every day, you know, different commercials.
Right.
So you can never like just think that you've done enough. You always got to kind of reinvent what you're doing.
True.
So I felt like, being that I was from a small town, how can I get myself out there? So I use social media as my main source to reaching like the masses of people.
Yeah, it's Afternoon Delight Radio Show. Clay Mercer, Ms. Tishima Gramby is with us. You've really made a name for yourself, not only here, but regionally, nationally. You've done your thing, and it all started right here in East City. Heredity Designs Salon, and I'm sure a lot of people are listening like, I go to that place regularly. Oh, yes, you probably do. Talk about your love for this business and where the idea came from to open up the salon.
Heredity Design Salon. It's funny because Heredity is something I don't push all the time.
Mm-hmm.
I mostly push Queen of Diamonds, but the both businesses is located under one roof.
Mm-hmm.
Heredity come from, my mother went to hair school. Like back when I was in hair school, to make a long story really short, I was done like really wrong. I had to start hair school over 3 times.
Okay.
So on that last go around, my mother decided to go to cosmetology school with me. And I'm going to tell you, like, if it wasn't for my mother, I don't think I would be out of hair school because she helped me, meaning I did most of her hair to try to complete my completions. Like, you had to have so many.
Wow.
And I, like, roller set her hair, took it down. I roller set her hair, took it down just so I can have enough completions so I can graduate with my class.
Mm-hmm.
So after hair school was complete, I remember, like, still sitting on my mom's couch. And I was just like, Mom, like, we're going to open up a shop. And I was like, I'm going to call it Heredity, passed down from you to me.
Wow.
So that's where Heredity comes from.
All the conversations we've had before, I never asked you how that came about. So that is an outstanding story. A major inspiration for you, your mother. So I love that.
Yes.
You know, and speaking of the conversations that we've had, during our conversations, it's always important to you to help yourself and others strive. And when people are successful in the community, it helps the community grow. And everybody kind of feels that. You always seem to be ready and willing to support others. And I've seen that in you. Where does that generosity come from?
It comes from because when I started out, it was like nobody was trying to help.
Mm-hmm.
So I told myself, once I get into a position, I'm going to make sure I help other people. You know what I'm saying? I did have a few people like doing the hair shows, like 89.9 always showed me love.
Mm-hmm.
You know, other business people like kind of showed me love because they knew how hard it was to get something started, like when I was doing my hair shows.
Mm-hmm.
But being from a small town, like it was like pulling teeth to get the community to really try to support what I was doing.
Yeah.
So I told myself once I got into a position where I can help somebody that I was going
to
do.
Yeah, that's pretty good, man. Again, it's Clay Mercer, Tishima Gramby. You're listening to Afternoon Delight Radio Show. As you grew your business and you're continuing to be successful, but it hasn't been a bed of roses, obviously, and it never is for successful entrepreneurs. You always go through trials and tribulations, ups and downs. For the listeners who are listening right now, especially the women, because we know there's a lot of women in the area who want to be entrepreneurs and they want their own business, what are some tips that you have to help them go through the good and bad times?
See, I start with the good first because I always try to highlight the good.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's obvious that it's going to be bad,
anything
you do. So I always try to highlight the good. First of all, you got to believe in yourself. And I don't care what it is you're going to do, you have to believe in yourself because you believe in yourself is going to make others believe in you.
Mm-hmm.
So first of all, is believe in yourself. Trust in the process. You got to trust the process. You know, the bumps, the bruises, the ups, the downs. You got to trust it.
Mm-hmm.
I remember praying one day and I told God, not, and I ain't trying to get too spiritual, but I remember saying, if you take me the long way, I don't care as long as I get there.
Wow.
That was my prayer. Like, as long as I get there, I don't care if you take me the long way.
Which can be hard for some people, because when they have those bumps in the road, it's almost like, this isn't meant for me. I got to go find something else. But exactly. you persevered, and that's a good tip for the listeners.
Exactly. So just, like, hang in there. You can't share your vision with everybody, you know. And then I would be a hypocrite if I tell you to write everything down, because I don't. And that's why I'm suffering from memory loss, because I keep it all in my hand. But they say write your vision down, make it plain.
Yeah.
So just write your vision down and make it plain. You don't have to have a lot of money. I think I opened up my salon. I was like 20 when I opened my salon. My hubby gave me $600. My grandparents gave me $600. That was the first month rent and deposit. And from there, I had it from there. Wow. I just needed that stepping stone to help me.
Yeah.
And after that, and that's why to this day, they can get anything.
That's pretty good. That's pretty good. It's all about family. And we've got the QOD Familia here with us. They're going to get into a whole lot of that. We got a lot more to get into, listeners. And Tishima, real quick, while we have some time, if people want to reach you on Instagram, they want to reach you on Facebook, what's some of the best ways for them to get in contact with you?
Facebook, Tishima Gramby, TishimaGramby. Instagram, I_am_theweaver. And Snapchat, theweaverdiva.
I like it all. Listen. Queen of Diamonds Hair Boutique. You want to know about it, we're going to tell you all about it right after I give you a little Aaliyah. Back and forth. Keep it right here on the Afternoon Daylight Radio Show.
Feel free to chime in on my Facebook, because I'll be answering your questions too as well. And doing the interview. So
what's going on, cuz? How you been? Hey, buddy. Congratulations on your little book.
Thank you, guys.
Joy, by the way.
Yeah. Can y'all hear me pretty good?
This is my girl. Doing it out here.
Twenty seconds, ladies. 20 seconds.
Have Mr. Mary.
You know where my daddy at, Carl?
This is City, Carolina. Carolina girls. Carolina girls.
Little country girls.
Baby girl Aaliyah, back and forth on Afternoon Delight Radio Show. Clay Mercer, my special guest, Miss Tishima Gramby, and the QOD Familia is here. I got to have them here more often. They're having too much fun. Again, if you go to our Facebook page, the WRVS 89.9 Facebook page, you can watch it live as it happens, and the ladies are looking lovely as usual. Again, it's Afternoon Delight Radio Show, and Tishima, right now, it's all about Queen of Diamonds, the hair boutique. It's a true beauty experience. One thing that makes it special is the chance for customers to feel the finest quality of virgin hair. And I want to get into that a little bit. First of all, tell us a little bit more about QOD, just the creation of it.
The creation of QOD, we started out, let's see. We started out, this girl came from Atlanta. Mm-hmm. She was selling these bundles. And she was like, this bundle of hair like $100. $100
Right.
But so you know, we're from Lizard City, we're a small town, we don't know nothing about no $100 mm-hmm. hair. So upon my investigation, I said, you know what, I think this might be the next best thing. This was like back in 2012 before mm-hmm. it got really saturated.
Right.
Now, trust me, I went through different vendors where I'm like, no, this ain't it. This right here, this not it. But I end up coming across the plug. And when I came across the plug, I'm like, yo, this hair is like some great hair. Like, you can reuse it, you can dye it, and all that stuff. Like, it's really worth the money because you don't have to keep going to the hair store, like, spending your money, like, you know, buying hair. Mm-hmm. So I still started, like, just having, like, a small little bit on hand just for my customers. And then I had a vision. So I was like, I need to put this online. I need to let this reach more people. So I got my manager, Sonny Fagan, to build a website. So we just started, you know, at that time, we were just still hustling bundles, mm-hmm. I call it. So once we got the website, I'm like, I need a little showroom to house these bundles. So I basically opened up a little spot in my shop. It was really small. And we opened up a little, you know, little showroom. And then from there, like, it just keep growing. So then I expanded it, and that's how, like, the physical location of QOD came. Got a showroom. Mm-hmm. Ended up getting a warehouse in China. And, like, the rest is history. Like, I've actually already grown the spot, the physical location. We really need another spot.
Okay.
So we're working on that. But that's how we got into, like, the bundles and the wigs and mm-hmm. stuff like that.
You talked a little bit about the qualities of virgin hair in these bundles. Give me a little bit more information on what distinguishes virgin hair from some of the other options out there on the market.
Virgin hair come from a donor, straight off someone's head, like the temples in India, different places.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, they actually sacrifice their hair for whatever blessing it is they're looking for.
Mm-hmm.
And then the factories take their hair and they basically sell it to people like me. The hair can last you for like years with proper care.
Wow.
You can treat the hair just like your own. The only mm-hmm. thing I recommend is us as African Americans, we like to put chemicals in our hair.
Correct.
The hair is not really African American hair, so I like to keep it chemical free. It keeps it moving.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's basically, I'm reading one of Larry's on West Yak.
Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, these people on Facebook Live. Yeah,
y'all familiar. I can't look at y'all comments. You made me out discombobulated.
Oh, my goodness. Yes.
So we have the high grade mm-hmm. version. And then we also have our middle grade Remy. And then we have the regular human hair. So I try to make sure I cater to every target audience, depending on what they're looking for, their budget, and like how long they want it to last. So we just carry the best in each genre of hair.
I like it. And for me, I'm a novice, so I'm a man, so it's kind of difficult for me to understand all the differences in the hair. But if they stop by, you can also give them all of the information they need. I mean, is it simple for people to just come in and ask what I would call dumb questions, but I don't know the answers to them.
They can ask questions. Like, I like when people stop by. I can't cater like I want to over the phone. That's why I have my clients like book me online, and I have as much information as possible yeah. online. But I encourage them to stop by and swing by. Like, we're open to the public. I don't even have to do your hair.
Yeah.
You can just swing by and purchase wigs or hair and let your favorite stylist install it. Like, it's all good. Like, we spread the word. Yeah.
It's afternoon delight radio show. Clay Mercer, Tishima Gramby with us. And there's a promo that was created that presents the QOD Familia. And it's very unique. Haven't seen anything like it here in EC. We got a crew here. Who was the mastermind behind the concept of this video? And how long did it take to complete the whole thing? Oh, okay. Had to be the weave thing. Yeah. Okay.
Because I used to do hair shows, so this doing a promo was like I can do a promo in my sleep because I used to do the hair shows, out here, pretty much by myself as far as getting it together. So the promo was like a walk in the park. Seriously, I'm not trying to, over exaggerate because I'm used to doing bigger projects. I just wanted something different instead of the everybody look cute, put your makeup on, and let's take these pictures, do a photo shoot. Like, I wanted something. I wanted something real. And I wanted to kind of reflect my life, because when people see me on Facebook, they just kind of get this one image of me just taking pictures. I wanted to show the different dynamics, the different sides of me and my crew. Like, we get it out the mud for real.
And everything seemed like it was shot right here in East City. Is that correct? And you said it didn't take very long.
No. I guess Larry did a very, very good job.
Shout out to Larry. Let's give him some love.
Shout out to Larry.
Yeah,
he did a very good job. He captured it. Like, he was in my mind. Like, I will always have the utmost respect for his creative, his creativity. It's amazing. Yeah. Because we was on Facebook. Like, we was on FaceTime. Mm-hmm. And I actually, Larry, I want to hear, chop it here, add the music here. One more second, let me add that. And he did all of that.
That's outstanding.
He did a lot of people would not, like, let you do that.
Yeah, yeah.
Listen, either you going to do this or I'm going to do it. big shout out to Larry.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I had the vision, and I'm not a great communicator. Mm-hmm. So I kind of think they're going to read my mind. And I kind of get a little frustrated. They keep asking me questions.
And you don't write things down. Right.
I'm like, y'all, just do this. Like, that's about right. Good. So they came through and they shut it down. And a lot of people is asking me about, did you jump that fence?
Did you
don't it look like I can jump a fence.
You're absolutely yes. There was a lot of athleticism shown in this promo, and the look and feel of the video seems very similar to other movies and scenes I've seen in the past. So, what influences are in this thing? Give me a high five of what influences are can be seen in this promo.
Y'all gonna see a little bit of dead presidents. Come on, y'all. Come on, y'all. Y'all gonna see a little bit of dead presidents.
Yeah. Belly? Is Belly in there?
Yeah. Well.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm sorry. I'm just telling you what I see, so okay.
Okay.
I mean, when I heard the steady,
from a music point of view, and a little belly, and then I wanted to take it back, so we went got NWA Express.
Yeah, you did that right, too.
We took it back to Otis Redding.
Shout out to Larry on that one, too.
I
think
the Mafia move was in there.
Yeah, that was in there.
So we had a little Mafia.
Yeah, Mafia was definitely
little Carlito's.
Yeah, because they kidnapped me.
Yeah. Oh, not bad.
So, I wanted to like pull for those great films.
Yeah.
And just put a twist on it.
Yeah.
Some
people may not have seen it yet, so I don't want to mess it up for you all. You can check it out on our Facebook page, Afternoon Delight Radio Show Facebook page, in a few moments. But give the listeners, the plot of what the promo was about from beginning to end. Like, give us the story.
Okay. Oh, wow.
We got time.
I'm about to give it to y'all.
Okay.
So, on a serious note, like I told you, it's really based off a true story.
Pretty much.
So, it comes from Sheena, right here, when we first started out.
Let me just pull back a little bit, because before we get into the plot of it, if you go to the Facebook page right now, you'll see the Familia here. We want to introduce the ladies. Let's go ahead and introduce them real quick so everybody knows who everyone is. So just introduce the people here to our listeners.
This is Sheena Bryant. Mm-hmm. Sheena Bryant plays she ain't got no name.
That's correct.
Dee actually is in part two.
Okay.
Dee Dee, Lock Queen.
Okay.
That's Shy. Everybody knows Shy, the one that's jumping the fences and jumping over that car. Yeah, let me jump
over that.
Good job.
So that's the lady. That's my team. We're missing one. She's not here today. That's okay. Athena. Okay. Athena played one of the mafia ladies in the film. And my little sister, she was one of the getaway drivers.
Not bad. We have some really good actresses in this one. Let me break down the plot for us. Tell us a little bit about this storyline.
Okay, so basically, I'm not going to tear up. I've known Tishima basically since I was, I have to say, 13 maybe?
Mm-hmm. I think it was younger.
And yeah, like maybe 10.
Yeah.
10 years old, and she's always been somebody that I looked up to, and I always wanted to work with her or for her in some way. Mm-hmm. And so, basically, she came to the hair store that I was working in and got me. I had been through a lot before that point, and my dream literally was to come work for her.
Wow.
And when I got my license in Ohio, and so after I got my license in Ohio, some things went wrong and I had to come back home and start over. And that was hard because I had a salon in Ohio and I had got my license up there. So when I came here, I started working at a hair store. And when I came to the hair store, she actually just walked in the hair store and was like, "What are you doing in here?"
Right.
And I was like, "I'm working." And so she was like, "Nah, you don't need to be in here. You need to come and work with me."
Wow.
And so basically that was almost the story that we tried to tell.
Okay.
In that promo is the fact that she basically came and she kidnapped me. From
threw you in the trunk. Slammed in the trunk. That was crazy. No.
12 years later. And she came in there and she got me. Yeah. And we've been rolling ever since.
Wow. On to bigger and better things. It's beautiful. Absolutely. The promo is outstanding. Y'all did a wonderful job. Congratulations to you ladies on that. I loved it. Again, the video, it can be seen on our Facebook page. If you go to the Afternoon Delight Radio Show Facebook page in a moment, you'll be able to watch it. The QOD Familia, and it looks like a very strong team that's around you. We've already introduced the ladies, but you can't do this without a strong team. So how important, well, first of all, just tell me the team that you have, how did they all just come together? I mean, obviously you've known these people for a very long time, and the only people you're going to bring into your circle are people that you trust and people that you know, and I think you have that team around you now.
That's true. Like when you see Shy like jumping the fence and jumping in the car, because Shy my go-to person. Shy ready to ride. She's ready to ride. And I wanted her to show that.
Yeah.
And so I'm going to let you talk
you're
about that.
You're going
to cry.
I can't talk.
Come up to the mic real quick, and we can pull that to her real quick as they make the change. And again, we got a lot of great people here in the studio again. Clay Mercer here with Tishima Gramby and the QOD Familia here on Afternoon Delight Radio Show. Go ahead and speak a little bit about it.
Okay. I'm Shy, everybody, the baby. I've been working with Tishima for, 2014? Around that time before I had my daughter. I braid. Whatever she needs, I assist her with. Whether it's helping a customer, bleaching, doing dye, whatever. Just whatever she needed.
Yeah.
I look to Tishima a lot. Like, she's a mentor.
Yeah.
So, I've always been involved in hair. I just never really wanted to pursue it.
Mm-hmm.
Like, that's not me, right?
Right, right.
I just like Tishima. I love her. She really did. Like, I went through something this year, and she... I'm going to cry.
No.
I'm
going
to cry.
It's okay.
No.
But I tell you what, it shows how heartfelt this team is. It's really a team effort, and I love that about what I see here. The laughing is all genuine, and I kind of feel that from you all. So I'm just so happy to have y'all here in the studio, and I'm just happy that you were able to come by here.
And then on top of that, since Dee's in part two, y'all, part two is coming very soon.
Mm-hmm.
So we're going to go ahead and tell you Dee part and how we connected in part two, because I want people to see, when I share stuff on Facebook, like, people know me in real life, so I'm not making up anything. Because these people gonna call me, I'm like, "Lord, I seen that little fake status." So because we real with each other like this.
Yeah.
So even with D, can you give some background on how we, you know, came into this thing?
As we switch it up a little bit again. And while these ladies are switching up, listeners, if you want to watch what's happening here in the studio, just go to the WRVS 89.9 Facebook page, and you can check us out on Facebook Live. And go ahead and give a little bit of your story about your connection to the Weave Diva here.
Well, my connection, I have known her for a while, since middle school, but as she was saying, she did hair shows. Mm-hmm. So as soon as I got out of hair school, I jumped right into her hair show, and from there, you know, she always been an inspiration to me. I look up to her, and you know, once I got out of the once I did the hair show, I just kept coming to her and like, You got a spot in the shop yet? You know, you got a spot. I mean, like, I was just, like, bugging her because something told me to, I need to be there. Yeah, I don't know, you know, what it was, but something, I didn't want to go nowhere else. It was just, and I just kept aggravating, like, you need some break, you need somebody to break. She was like, no, I'm okay, you know. And she was like, no, I don't need nobody yet. Yeah. And I mean, I really kept aggravating her till she finally, like, you know what, come in. Let me interview you, see what's going on. And then she gave me the chance, and you know, and it's been
like ever since.
It's been beautiful.
It's crazy because as y'all know now, that's Lock Queen, and she has built a brand without a brand.
Yes.
She's a beast. You know what I'm saying? And I'm always for the underdog because to keep it 100, D was the underdog. Mm. You know what I'm saying? D was the underdog. And I remember when she first started out, she'll come to me, how does this look? I'm like, nah, D.
That ain't it.
And she'll go back in the room and she'll get frustrated. But then she took what I said and she got her niche, which was locks.
Yeah.
And now she's a beast. Wow. She's traveling. She's for the Raleigh. And she do hair every third weekend.
Yeah, every third weekend I'm in Raleigh and Garner.
So you're traveling a little bit yourself right about now. And you know what? It's interesting because you talked about how you help out the community and you're always willing and the generosity that you show. But it seems like there's going to be extra leaves and branches from this tree. I mean, it seems like everybody has a chance to step out and do their thing and it all comes right back home. So that's a beautiful thing about family. And that's wonderful what I see here.
I encourage them because, like, the famous lines of Jay, I can't think of everything else. I'm sorry.
Oh. That's no problem. You started off right now.
Nobody will fall because everybody will be each other's crutches.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I don't know it verbatim, but that's what it is. You know, if everybody in your crew is rugged, nobody will fall because everybody will be each other's crutches. And I need more than just myself. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? I need other ones. Like when I'm down, I need them to say, keep going.
Definitely. You know,
that's what it's all about.
So. I remember the hair shows, and I want to pop off a little bit about that. And I was at another location at the time when you came by, and I did the promo and everything and put it on the radio. People really enjoyed that. It was something different, not something that came here very often. It was kind of one of a kind. And then it stopped for a period of time. Is that something that could happen in the future where it could come back? Is that something that you're even interested in right now with everything else that you have going on?
I never say never, right?
Okay.
But you know, when I stopped doing hair shows, it was to pursue my journey being a celebrity stylist. And I was traveling everywhere, and I would get paid to just do a 7-minute set.
Mm-hmm.
And like that money was really good. So it didn't take much thinking.
Yeah, yeah.
So, but I'll never say never. Like gotcha. I had a good team behind me. I'm getting older now. I'm actually trying to retire and work my way out of behind the chair.
Gotcha.
Anything is possible.
I like it. Listen, we talk about family, Queen of Diamonds. It's a family and it's a movement. What is next for QOD? And what is the long-term vision of Queen of Diamonds?
What is next? Like, I want to have, like, QOD as a franchise. I network with a lot of other stylists.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, if they don't have their own brand, I want them to be able to get into Queen of Diamonds and open up a boutique in their town where they're at.
Good.
You know, almost like a chick from that.
Mm-hmm.
So that is my long-term QOD. I love the wig side. I love that side.
Yeah.
So that's the long-term goal.
I like it. Again, for the listeners who are checking in right now, they want to learn more about Queen of Diamonds. They want to come to the boutique. They want to learn more about everything that you're doing. Let's go ahead and break down the location and the phone number that they can reach you.
Queen of Diamonds is located in Elizabeth City, North Carolina, 420 North Hughes Boulevard, Suite A. We're also online. Our website is www.queenofdiamondshairboutique.com. Customer service is 252-421-3911. like stop by. We specialize in custom units. And I'm telling y'all, I might share it today, if not today, tomorrow. Like my team is so talented. My team is so talented. And I'm gonna show you guys. Like we just dropped a new wig line. And I guess I'll probably upload it today. So we got some heat for y'all this summer.
I like it. I like it. See, she brings me exclusives. That's why I like it when she comes through. Tishima, the QOD Familia, thank you all for stopping by and being a part of this. And I hope that y'all come back real, real soon. Because y'all know this feel good flavor. So I need y'all to roll through here.
Thank you.
I appreciate that. Anytime, anytime. Listen, Larry, if y'all want to go to the Facebook page right now, you can check them out. I'm going to leave the video running. And if you missed any of it, it'll be up there on Facebook Live. You can watch it all day long. And check out the video on the Afternoon Delight Radio Show Facebook page. That'll be up there in just a few moments. Listen, we got more Feel Good Flavor on the way and a chance for one of you to win a hot and ready piece of dinner from our friends over at Little Caesars. The chance to win is coming up right here on the Afternoon Delight Radio Show.